Here's the grid for our next race rolling out now. This is race group number 3 for production sports cars are under 1.5 liters. So this group has MG Midgets and Austin Healey Sprites, some Minis, some Alfa Romeos, small Alfa Romeos. And the pole sitter is an Elva Courier, an English small production English sports car. In this country, most of the Elva Couriers were bought and used as race cars, but they really were a production two-seat sports car. And the pole sitter is from Allison Park, Pennsylvania, car 379, Nate Shigliano, in his 1959 Elva Courier, with the best time in qualifying, 225.988, almost exactly a 226 lap during qualifying yesterday. Starting second, car number 821, is Garth Knorr from Palm Coast, Florida, in a 1961 MG Midget. Starting third, car 57, Charlie Doland from Pittsburgh in a 1957 MGA. Starting fourth, Craig Seifert from Oakdale, Pennsylvania, or Seifert, in a 1968 Austin Healey Sprite. Starting fifth is car 371, David Good from Camledon, Ontario, in an MGA. Starting sixth, Mark race that started the afternoon races, the all-Italian car race, he pulled off for a while, and then later on the car started and he resumed racing after perhaps a lap or two had gone by. So I don't know whether that was a heat-related problem or not, but I certainly hope that we see Bradley Price here as the cars come down to take the green flag to start this race. Starting eighth is car 41, Joe Plunkett from Coopersburg, Pennsylvania, in a Mini Cooper S. Starting ninth, car 7, Ian Wisman from Pittsburgh in a 1961 Austin Mini. Starting 10th, car 78, Alan Patterson III of Pittsburgh in a 1961 Austin Healey Sprite. Here's your pace car. No, this is the first of the safety cars coming by, the Mercedes. Starting 11th, car 53, David Smith from Carlisle, Pennsylvania in a Sprite, 59 Sprite Mark I. That would be a Bug-Eye Sprite. Starting 12th, car 137, David Holmes of Elmira, Ontario, in a 57 MGA. Starting 13th, car 555, Santos Spadaro of Rybrook, New York, in a 58 Alfa Romeo Sprint Veloce. Starting 14th, car 43, Daniel Todd from Red Hill, Pennsylvania, in a 59 Alfa Giulietta Spider. Starting 15th, Bill Schwartz, formerly of Pittsburgh, now of Ligonier, Pennsylvania, Dr. William Schwartz, in his 59 Porsche 356A. Starting 16th, car 147, Tom Dick from Winchester, Virginia, in a 1962 MGA. Starting 17th, car 50, James Byers from Alexandria, Virginia, in an MG Midget. Starting 18th, car 948, Jeff Graham from Southern Shores, North Carolina, in a 58 Austin Healey Bug-Eye, or as he puts it, Frog-Eye Sprite. Starting 19th, car 27, Jim Arnett from Westminster, Maryland, in a 62 Austin Mini Cooper. Starting 20th, car 528, Jerry Smith from Summit, New Jersey, in a 1962 Devon C. And last on the grid, car 70, Robert Van Kirk from Stowe, Ohio, in a 1965 MG Midget. So we're expecting the cars. There they are, coming out of the Serpentine. And green flag is out, and we have a start. And Nate Shigliano takes the lead from the pole through the first turn. And they're off. I thought I saw, when they came by, I thought I saw a Volvo in this group. We do have a Volvo 544 racing this weekend. Is not listed officially as in this group. We'll have to check again. I may have just been imagining things when I looked out at the pack of cars as they came by us, but I thought I saw the Volvo in this race group. Perhaps not. So we're underway. These are slated as eight lap races. are several members of the Shiliano family that race. Oliver Shiliano, Nate Shiliano is the pole sitter and at the moment leader in this race underway. I think we said this earlier that when this event started some years ago, there were very few Pittsburgh area drivers. A few, Alan Patterson, Dick Scott nearby, and Joe Malloy and George Schaefer from Somerset and some others. But now when you look down the entry list here at the Pittsburgh Vintage Grand Prix, you find very many racers who've come to run the Pittsburgh Vintage Grand Prix. And I don't know how many other events that they run through the season. And there may well be some vintage racers who have bought a car and learned racecraft just to do this event, because it's such a special event. And of course, if you live locally, it's your local vintage race. One of the biggest, if not the biggest, vintage car race weekend in the nation, and our events here at Schenley Park. No tickets required, all free to the public. Nate Shiliano leads. Garth Knorr in second. Charlie Dolan in third. Craig Seifert in fourth. This car is 78 going by. Alan Patterson, the third. Well, I did not see a Volvo that time by, so I must have been hallucinating a little earlier. But this group of under 1 lap down. Let's see. Fast lap was by Charlie Dolan. He's in third place, but turned the quickest lap so far, a 228.1 by car 57. Charlie Dolan, I think, in third place at the moment. So if he's turning the quickest times, he could have the opportunity to move ahead. Early stages of these races, the field is very much clustered. They come by, they're gone. It's silent for a while. And then they come by again. The longer the race goes on, the more the field stretches out. And finally, by the end of the race, there's a car coming by every 3 seconds or so. You've heard several of the drivers that we've talked to after the races thank and salute the workers, because the drivers know that they wouldn't be able to have the fun that they have without the workers. Without workers, there is no racing. And they make a point of saying that, and they truly mean it. Well, we have a new leader, and it's Charlie Dolan. It's the driver that I said a moment ago. He was faster than everybody else, and he would have an opportunity to move ahead, and he is now, in fact, at the head of this race. We have a report of a car off, drivers left, and that's right at the bottom of the serpentine here. We can't see it from here, but it's just around the corner from us, and there's a picture of it. Actually, we're looking at it here on the monitor. It is car 821, and that's Garth Knorr. That's Garth Knorr, who had been running second, started second, And it looks as though he slid off. And I don't know whether is he parked there or did he actually impact the tree. Anyway, blue 821 is off. It was great to see the picture. I don't know whether that camera can still take a look. There's the car. Okay, it's safely up in the grass, and that's good to know. And I think we're seeing that the driver is out of the car. Is he? Yeah, I believe he must be. Looks as though the car is safely off course. And if that's the case, race control may decide that it's in a safe place and we can continue the race without a yellow flag. So that would be great if that was the case. You can see the corner workers down there, down by the stop sign there, and they're the ones who are responsible for taking care of that driver and that car, and it appears that they have done that. So he'll get a rope tow back in to his pit at the end of the race. There's your leader, the red MGA of Charlie Dolan. And look at the lead. Nate Chiliano is in second. And looks like Craig Seifert in the white Sprite is in third, car 930. Actually, I think he pronounces his name Seifert, and I keep saying Seifert because I think it's spelled that way. But I think that's Bill Schwartz's red Porsche 356 heading up the hill there. Car 366 we just saw go by turn one. The corner workers are also looking at the rear of another car. Is that car 79? They think that they might be seeing a gas leak, which would be of concern not necessarily to that driver, but to other drivers behind. A slippery racing surface behind that car. So corner workers, again, they're always observing not just the racetrack surface, but also looking at the cars as they come by, as they come toward them, as the cars go by, and as they go off in the distance. And that's part of the job of the corner workers, and that's why they're not just sitting out there on the corner. They are the eyes and ears of race control here at the start-finish line. Well, double check on that number, car 79. I'm not seeing a 79 on my list, unless it's our leader 379. So we'll try to follow up on that. Here is our leader. No, I take that back. Yes, that's our leader, Charlie Dolan, right? 379 right here is Nate Giuliano in second place. And Craig Seifert in third. Fastest lap of the race so far, Charlie Dolan, car 57, 226.4. And that is faster than his fastest time in qualifying. And we haven't seen that occur very often today. Car 70 there, Robert Van Kirk of Stowe, Ohio. MG Midget. If you watch the cars go through a turn one, you often see puffs of smoke from the rear end of those cars. It may be a little tire smoke as the rear end of the car skids a little bit on that first turn. see if we can't get a look at Bill Schwartz's red Porsche car 366 this time by, and see if we see a little bit of smoke out of the rear of that Porsche. I think it's the only Porsche in this race. Bill Schwartz, who started 15th, longtime racer here at the Vintage Grand Prix. And again, former Pittsburgher, now residing in Ligonier. A Porsche enthusiast, racer, and has at least one Porsche streetcar as well. Car 7 has pulled off. Is that right, or is that Station 7? Is it car number 7? Charlie Dolan, your race leader, has just pulled into the pit. And I don't know whether he was commanded to stop at the pit or whether he has a problem that they're dealing with. I'm looking over there and I can't exactly tell, because on occasion if a driver is called into the pit, that's where he would stop. The corner workers thought he was dragging something in the rear suspension. Meanwhile, car 909, Neil McCabe, had a spin and go at some point. Didn't hit anything, didn't hurt anything. And continue. That's car 909, Neil McCabe in the MG Midget. Robert Van Kirk just went by, and I have to say the engine is not sounding too great on that car. And a corner station has called in that they thought he might have been dragging something as well. Car 70, Robert Van Kirk, the MG Midget. Well, meanwhile, Charlie Dolan sits in the pit lane. It looks like he's in a position that would allow him to pull out if the problem can be solved, but he's continues to sit there. And that should mean that we have a new leader. And I'm going to guess that the new leader would be Nate Sciliano, but that's not been confirmed yet. Car sits safely off the track, just down the road, just a little bit from start-finish, just before the finish line. Well, here's Nate Sciliano. He becomes our leader right now. And the fastest time of the race, the fastest lap, has just been set by Nate Sciliano, a 225.1. Again, the corner workers looking at the back of car 70. They think maybe he's got something dragging, they think, from the rear suspension. Could be a sway bar. If that's determined to be the case, they might give him the so-called meatball flag. And he's going to get the meatball. He will get the meatball flag. That's a... big orange circle on a black background that tells the driver, please pull into the pits. We think there's something wrong with your car. We want to take a look at it. So it's not a disciplinary flag. It's a safety-related flag. And there he is. He's just come by the start stand, so he's just gotten the meatball, and indeed he is pulling to the pit. Robert Van Kirk in car 70. And his Someone over there from the safety folks or the scrutineering crew is taking a look at the rear of his car and telling him, we think you've got a problem in the rear suspension. And in fact, he is retiring. He's going up into the paddock. Robert Van Kirk. Showing Joe Plunkett in third place now, car 41. Joe Plunkett from Coopersburg, Pennsylvania, in the Mini Cooper S, a 67 Mini Cooper S. Neil McCabe is shown in fourth in car 909. And tell you fifth place in just a moment. Nate Giuliano has completed seven laps so far, so the noose comes out. I don't know whether you've actually seen the noose, but it's hung from the finish line. You can see it being displayed to the drivers on their as they begin their last lap. It's our message that they should hang in there. Showing Bradley Price, car 227, the I think it's white Alpha Giulietta Spider in fifth place. Here comes Bill Schwartz's Porsche, and yeah, it does make a little bit of smoke out the back end. Not doesn't look too bad. Might be typical Porsche smoking from the early models, the 356s. His is a 356A, which means it's from 1959. So last lap for this, our race group number three. I think there were two races remaining today. Four is our next race group. That's under 2 liter production sports cars. And then race group six, our fastest cars of the weekend, formula cars and sports racing. Here's our leader, and there is the checkered flag out for Nate Giuliano. Pole sitter, fell behind for a while, and back in the lead. Greg Seifert, 9:30. Finishes in second place. There's car 41, the yellow Mini Cooper finishes in third. That's Joe Plunkett. So there you have it. We have, out of I think six races today, we have held four with two to go this afternoon. Weather conditions still holding out, so we're in good shape. This afternoon, I understand that earlier weather predictions were that we could get rain by 5 o'clock. Latest I heard that had been pushed back to 7 o'clock tonight. Car 350 right at the end, report of a spin and go around around station 6. So we'll head over to our victory circle and congratulate the winners of this, our Group 3 race.
Can I help you out this morning?
Yeah.
I said, can I help you out?
Oh, sure, yeah, I'll do it.
Please, Doc.
Nate Chiliano, boy, that was great. You had a wonderful race. You started on the pole. Something happened. You weren't in the lead, and then you won the race.
I have to hats off to Charlie and Garth. They drove phenomenal races. Those two guys were fast. Unfortunately, it looks like they both had car problems. The three of us were having a great battle up there. It would have been real interesting, but I'm glad I'm here, not them.
Congratulations. Now, what was the comment you said just a moment ago about 12 years?
12 years I've been coming here. It's the first time I made it to the podium.
Excellent. Congratulations. Hard-earned race win, and congratulations. You deserve it.
Thank you, Ted. Appreciate it.
All right, there's your winner. And second place, let's talk to Craig. Okay, you have to tell me, Seifert or Seifert?
Seifert.
That was super, was it not?
Oh, it was a blast. It was a blast. The heat was a little bit much, but fun race. Fun race. You guys put on a great event. That's all I got. Second's nice. I like second.
Second's excellent.
I would have liked first, but, you know, I'll take second.
And the car, anything special about your car?
No, I'm just happy it made it through the whole race, so because it's English, and it's 50 years old, so you never know.
Yeah, but a lot of the cars in your race are English and 50 years old, so that's the game. Congratulations. Great race. Will you come back?
Oh, yeah, I'll be back. We all keep our fingers crossed when we're out there running.
Congratulations. Joe, we're happy to see a mini up there on the podium.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Thanks for everybody coming out. A lot of fun. Can't wait to go back to the next one.
Temperatures, I mean, everybody, all of you guys, when you get out of the cars, you really look just soaking wet.
It's a little warm out there. But when you're running, you don't feel it. You just got the adrenaline going. So it's a great time. Thanks again for everybody.
Glad you came. Congratulations. Glad to see you on the podium this weekend. Look for the winner of the drive of the race, the Workers' Award, and that's Alan Patterson, the third. The fourth. The Patterson clan, I want to say clan has been here because we heard the pipe corps, the pipe band playing earlier today, and they're right over there, and I asked them to do me a favor and not play until we finish the interviews.
That's certainly a good idea. This is a wonderful event, Ted. Absolutely stunned by this award. Certainly wasn't expecting it. I got to thank all the workers, everybody who puts this on. What a wonderful event, and the crowd certainly for coming out and supporting us. Spectacular event. This is a great unexpected pleasure.
It's a wonderful thing to do that on your home race.
Absolutely, it is. Exactly. Yes. Thank you.
Congratulations. Glad you had a good time this weekend.
Absolutely. Fabulous time. Wonderful. Thank you.
Alan Patterson, the third.